Right now at 6:30, South Carolina left without a functioning death penalty for years. Securing lethal injection drugs has become a difficult task across the country as drug makers refuse to sell to states under pressure from anti-death penalty activists.
Fox 46's Matt Grant has more on the measures that lawmakers are taking to resurrect the death penalty.
Convicted killer Richard Moore's delayed execution isn't the first time South Carolina struggled to get the drugs needed for a lethal injection.
Plead guilty.
In 2017, serial killer Todd Kohlhepp was sentenced to life after pleading guilty to murdering seven people.
This was a death penalty case, no question about it.
But prosecutors didn't seek the ultimate punishment, in part because they said South Carolina doesn't have a functioning death penalty. 37 inmates are currently sitting on death row, the state unable to obtain the drugs needed to carry out their sentence.
They don't want to have anything to do with it for fear of retribution.
Governor McMaster has previously called for lawmakers to pass a shield law to keep secret the suppliers of drugs used for executions. Texas is currently doing that. Prison officials there tell Fox 46, "We use pentobarbital, and we have it in stock." Palmetto state lawmakers are debating a bill that would default death by electric chair if lethal injection drugs are not available.
The electric chair is both gruesome and inhumane.
Robert Dunham is the executive director of the nonprofit Death Penalty Information Center. He says there have been more than 80 documented cases of botched electric chair executions.
When it is really badly botched, you can see prisoners' heads catching on fire, blood dripping down from underneath the hoods.
But State Senator Shane Martin of Spartanburg supports the electric chair and the firing squad if it means justice for victims.
What would you say to critics who would say that the electric chair and the firing squad are both gruesome and inhumane?
I would tell them to look to the victim's father or somebody when something horrific was done to their child. That's what I would point to.
In Charlotte, Matt Grant, Fox 46.